there are two types of iron, heme iron and non-heme iron. That's H-E-M-E. So heme iron comes exclusively from animals, whereas non-heme iron is found in both animals and plants. For example, beef contains about 40% heme iron and 60% non-heme iron. So that may surprise you, but animals actually have heme and non-heme iron. Why do we care about this? Well, iron deficiency is the most common nutritional deficiency on the planet, affecting 2 billion people. And an iron deficient human is less resilient, more likely to succumb to infections, have poor work performance, have developmental disabilities, and for mothers and children with iron deficiency, you know, mortality is greatly increased. So when we're looking at dietary or supplemental interventions to restore optimal iron status, it is vital that sourcing is considered. Because even though pound for pound spinach is a much higher source of iron than, say, beef, the ability of the body to uptake and use the iron is actually the opposite. Humans are only able to absorb about 7% of the non-heme iron, which is found in the vegetables, whereas we can absorb 15 to 35% of the heme iron, which is found exclusively in animal products, like chicken, beef, turkey, lamb, fish. This is often why those who hold to a vegetarian and vegan food lifestyle will find they need to supplement with iron to maintain optimal levels. We name the iron heme iron and non-heme iron because the heme iron contains a hemoglobin protein attached to the iron mineral, whereas the non-heme iron does not have the hemoglobin protein attached to the iron. So heme iron from animals has an upper limit of absorption. So even though we can absorb iron more easily, more readily from, say, beef compared to spinach, there actually is an upper limit to the amount of iron we can absorb in the form of heme iron. Heme iron is saturable. Basically, along the brush border of the intestines, there's a protein that binds heme iron for absorption. However, research so far is showing that the body will only increase the number of these binding proteins so much, and heme iron then stops. The absorption of heme iron, that is, stops. This is not the case with non-heme iron sources, and could be why only 40% of iron in meat is in the form of heme iron, and the other 60% is in the form of non-heme iron. People are often confused when it comes to supplementing with heme iron sources versus non-heme iron sources, thinking that heme iron in supplemental form must have the same higher absorption rate as does heme iron in the whole food, you know, piece of steak. But this is not the case. In fact, studies have shown in patients with highly compromised absorption capacity, such as with gastric bypass surgery or gastric sleeve surgery, that heme iron absorption in supplemental form is actually lower than non-heme iron absorption, such as we would get from vegetables. So when aiming to overcome iron deficiency, utilizing red meats and supplemental non-heme iron or vegetarian sourced iron is high value. In fact, consuming red meat along with a non-heme iron supplement actually increases the absorption of the non-heme iron. When supplementing with non-heme iron sources, be sure to take them away from soybeans, dairy, eggs, calcium supplements, and coffee or tea, as those will decrease non-heme iron absorption. On the flip side, malic acid from pears and apples, citric acid from citrus fruits, lacto-fermented vegetables like sauerkraut, vitamin C supplements significantly enhance non-heme iron absorption. In fact, vitamin C is shown to increase non-heme iron absorption by up to 400%, and lacto-fermented vegetables can increase non-heme iron absorption by 200%. Getting your heme iron from meat and then supplementing with high absorbing non-heme iron sources can be a fantastic way to speed your iron optimization and get your life back. All right, I'm Dr. Matt. If this is helpful, please like, subscribe, put comments below, let us know what you have questions about.